Hey everybody, it's Jang here with another one of the second wave 2013 LEGO City sets. This is set number 60015 with 274 pieces. It's called the Coast Guard Plane. And as you can see, it comes with not just the Coast Guard Plane, but also a pretty decent sized fishing boat. Let's put it all together in the speed build and then check it out. Alright, here we go. All completed. Let's check out the minifigures. First off, this is your Coast Guard pilot. He's the pilot for the plane. And there's really nothing new here. There's nothing particularly interesting. It's existing parts, existing prints that we've had on sets that were released before this one. And it's just, you know, this wave or this version of Coast Guard is using the all orange look. Then you have two fishermen, and I don't know, you might want to think of this as a father-son duo, or you know, you don't have to if you don't want to, but that's the way I look at it. And you got an older guy and a younger guy, and you can see this guy here has the tools on his kind of overall top. I'm not sure if he actually has a full set of overalls on though, because it's got a different color of legs down here. Got the gray hair with a little bit of a comb over effect going on with this guy, just a little bit. And on the back we have no print whatsoever. Got the short bill dark red hat on this guy. And there you go, takes care of your minifigures. So that said, what are we going to look at first? We're going to look at the plane, we're going to look at the boat. Well, I'm going to look at the boat first because I want to spend more time looking at the plane afterwards. So for a set, you know, if you hadn't seen the pictures of the set in advance, if you saw something that said this is going to be a Coast Guard plane set, I don't think you would expect to get this much of a boat in there. Makes sense that they would include something for, you know, something to rescue, something to help. But I'm a little bit surprised that they gave you this much to go with it. However, it kind of factors into the price I'll talk about later. This is a pretty nice boat. It's got a light gray hull. I haven't seen that color in this size of hull before. It doesn't mean it hasn't been released before. It's just I haven't seen it. And it's got the nice reddish brown top piece. This is a unitary hull, which means that it, you know, it's all completely sealed up. This is all one piece down here at the bottom, and it will actually float. So that's a very good thing. Now the I like the color scheme of this boat. It looks kind of real. It looks like it's not trying to be flashy and toy-like. You know, it's just kind of getting down to just the realism of, you know, not always the brightest colors for stuff that's actually done for work out in the field. You got your captain's spot right there where he stands to control the boat. Not really covered up from the back, but I do like the use of this inverted windshield piece here. Got a little bit of your antenna up here, a little bit of radar dish. Nice details to this one. I like that. A little bit of chain here. Got a mooring point here. Got a bucket. What's that bucket for? Well, as you can see, this thing has sprung a leak. It's taken on water pretty fast, so your two fisherman characters need to be on board and probably going back and forth on the duty of bailing out the boat, because you've only got one bucket here and you need to keep that water down. The boat's probably going to sink anyway, but you need to basically make up some time, you know, keep yourself afloat, because there's no There's no raft or anything here. There's no dinghy. There's no way to get off the boat safely without jumping in the water. That water might be pretty cold, so you probably don't want to be jumping into it, get hypothermia. So they need to go back and forth using the bucket to bail out water until the Coast Guard arrives. And they don't know what form of vehicle or transport that the Coast Guard is going to use to find them. They don't even know their exact position. They have a general rough position, but the Coast Guard are going to have to really search for these guys out there because they don't have an exact. I guess their GPS isn't working, or maybe they didn't even have one. They've got a couple of fish that they did manage to catch out there. This is a nice little setup they have here with the long fishing rods. So you get some nice pull off of that. You can actually adjust these out to almost look like it's trawling, but you know, just the long lines coming off the sides. And the default way that they have you assemble these rods actually has the line a bit too long. You're supposed to cut it to 12 inches, they said, and that just leaves it going way, way back. And then when you attach it here, it ends up not looking good. It's supposed to have just a little bit of a bow shape down here, but when you have 12 inches, you just have extra string just dangling all over the place. So I would recommend going a little bit shorter than they ask for on that. You know, just use these inner points right here where the string is attached. Oops, trying to get this reattached over here on the side, so we'll just talk about that. The string is attached here just by that little 1x1 round plate. It's not actually tied, so you can go ahead and tie down this end, then bring your string in here, see how you feel about it. You can tighten it or loosen it before you cut it off completely. But other than that, ends up working pretty well. Nice little, actually large outboard motor setup. Does not have a prop on it. Not sure exactly what sort of design they're going for here, but it has some nice detail. Okay, let's move on to the main thing that this whole set is all about. It's about this plane, Coast Guard plane. And you know what? I like this plane. I like this plane a lot. I think it came out great. I think it looks really, really good. Nice, large floats here. Nice, very sturdy connection between them. Got the high wing design, got large triple blade rotors. Looks like it's got some pretty big inlets and, you know, respectable detail around the engine. It's not all the finest detail, but it works out. These are parts that we've had before. For the nice long nose kind of business jet sort of front end, but it does, that style I think does really work well with this design of airplane. You got a large enough tail. That's a nice look right there. That actually looks really good. I could just see just kind of following that along, a camera angle just following this thing as it flies through the air like that, you know, just spinning the propellers. Looks pretty realistic. It's got really nice proportions to it. I think that's the highlight of this, is just that the proportions are really good. And then your cockpit can just be removed. It's pretty easy. It's not attached with too many points. They do have, I mean, this is your little cockpit area where your pilot sits. He's got two levers here for control. I'm not sure exactly what control scheme that they have there, but he's got a wrench in case anything goes a little bit wrong with the plane when it touches down out in the field or out in the water. Might also be able to help out any people who are in trouble, need a little bit of help with the mechanical elements of whatever they're on. And then you also have a fire extinguisher. That's very important. And well, there's something missing here, I think. Something big. And that is an opening, a large space to put the people that you're rescuing. You see, they sent out an airplane to find to help the fishing boat, because like I said, the fishing boat, the folks on it, they don't know exactly where they are. They may have drifted a little bit, lost power or something. They were able to get a call into the Coast Guard, but they need a large area. They know roughly where they are, but not exactly. So a large area needs to be searched, so that's why the Coast Guard sent out an airplane. So they sent out an airplane. It's a seaplane. It finally locates the fishing boat, comes down, makes a nice landing in the water hopefully, you know, it's not, the water's not too rough. It makes a nice landing, kind of taxis up fairly close to it. You've got your pilot, and he doesn't have any helpers with him. He doesn't have anybody to go, you know, make the connection with the folks who are stranded. So he gets out himself to help these guys get onto the plane, but then where do they go? You've got these two guys are getting rescued. They have no place to go. There's no space inside of this plane for them. So they end up just in the course of normal play, you have to attach them to the floats out here. That's probably your best bet. Just stick them on there, which is fine. You know, it's fine for play, I think. Then you just put your pilot back in there. But I just think it would have been a lot nicer if they actually included a place for these people to go. You know, some just space under there. Unfortunately, there isn't room within this design. It just doesn't leave enough space in there, you know, to put anything without completely just making the whole thing far too weak to not even hold itself together. But I think that's a big miss on the part of Lego with this set. I think they could have done a lot better with that. They could have gotten a lot more realistic sort of play experience if they did like they do with the helicopters, of having a nice large open space. But that would have required a different design of plane, or a much larger plane. This set ends up being $50. $50 US, I believe, is the general price range. You might see it a little bit higher, a little bit lower, depending upon what store you're looking at. And to me, I mean, the price per part is okay. It's not great. It's a little bit on the high, a little bit on the high side of what they do. But I don't know. I do very much like this plane, and I would love to be able to get that plane for, say, $30-$35. I think that would be that feels like a good price to me for what you get. So saying that, this boat then becomes a $15 piece, and you'll figure the plane with a minifigure or two for $35, and then this boat with one or two minifigures, you know, counting for the value there, for $15, it's okay. But personally, I just wish that there was a little bit more playability to this set with just lost his cap, with the ability to really pick these guys up, have some life, you know, life jackets or some life preservers or an extra raft or something else, and then the ability to actually take them on board the plane instead of just attaching them to the outside where they'll get blasted with 200, 300 mile an hour wind directly from the props. But otherwise, still like the design of this. It's really going to be up to you to determine whether you think, based on how much you like each one, whether you think that they're a good value as an entire set. But that does it for my look at these. That's pretty much sums up my thoughts on these. If you have your own thoughts on them, please do feel free to post up your comments and share your thoughts with the rest of the LEGO community, because everybody's opinion can be different, and everybody's opinion is valuable because it's their own opinion. And nobody has to agree with it or disagree with it. It's just sharing. So I really appreciate that, and I really appreciate you watching my videos, and I hope that you'll stick around to watch more, because I've got more reviews coming, more builds, and more custom stuff too. So talk to you again soon.